This winter and its seasonal celebrations are different than those of other years. We are limited in gathering and celebrating, even in our own homes and with our own families. And politicians promise us a dark winter. It's ominous. But it's also a reflection of the ages. We have arrived in the winter of history, a dark winter that will conclude this current age and current world. As you might wonder how Christmas celebrations will take place, it's good to wonder what you were celebrating to begin with. For many, it has not been anything else than a gathering with family, with presents and a fine meal. It's not a biblical feast to begin with. But I spoke of that in previous years, and you can find those messages online. Check our website for that. Just click on videos, select feasts, and type Hanukkah or Christmas. Alternatively, you can check the feasts playlist on our YouTube channel. But I know that for many, the limitations on the celebrations make this winter darker than ever. But that means that your light has to shine brighter than ever. Does it? Jewish people celebrate around this time the Feast of Hanukkah. Of that too, it is said that it is not biblical. But is that so? Hanukkah is an everyday Hebrew word, and it means dedication. It celebrates a rededication of the Second Temple. And this happened during the period between the Old and the New Testament. And therefore, it's not found in our Bibles. However, it was an established feast in Jesus' time. In John 10, verse 22-23, we read, "And it was at Jerusalem the feast of the dedication," that's Hanukkah, "and it was winter. And Jesus walked in the temple in Solomon's porch." That confirms the text that we can find in the deuterocanonical books of the Maccabees. Moreover, like the other feasts, it appears to be an appointed time. We find its date also in the Old Testament and even in relation to the dedication of that same temple. In Haggai 2, verse 18, we read, "Consider now from this day and upward, from the 24th day of the 9th month, even from the day that the foundation of the Lord's temple was laid, consider it." It is actually a very prophetic feast that has everything to do with the end of the age. As we just read, Jesus was walking in Solomon's porch, which was the east side of the temple. That is the side where Jesus entered on Palm Sunday, the eastern gate. And it is the same place where he will enter Jerusalem again, after his second coming. It is the very reason why the Muslims closed that gate in the 1500s. See Ezekiel 44 and Psalm 24 speaking about that. So the feast is linked to both the dedication and the rededication of the Second Temple in 515 BC and 165 BC. We can confirm that with scripture. Moreover, tradition tells us that the wise men visited Jesus also during Hanukkah, about 1.5 years after his birth. In a way, they dedicated him for his earthly work. And this is symbolized in the gifts that they gave him, gold, frankincense and myrrh, which point respectively to Jesus' work as king, as priest and as sacrifice. But there is also a yet future fulfillment. And for that, it's important to know that Hanukkah starts 75 days after Yom Kippur, from the 10th day of the 7th month to the 25th day of the 9th month. This period of 75 days is significant, as we find it in the book of Daniel. In Daniel 12, verse 11 and 12, we read, "And from the time that the daily sacrifice shall be taken away, and the abomination that maketh desolate set up, there shall be 1290 days. Blessed is he that waiteth and cometh to the 1335 days." It needs little calculation And the abomination of desolation takes place in the midst of the 7 years, and as we can read in Daniel 9:27. And so there are 1260 days left after that. But here it speaks of 1335 days, and that is the difference of 75 days. In other words, we find these 75 days at the end of the tribulation period as a time of restoration and rededication of the earth, of Jesus' kingdom, and of the millennial temple. And all this is in line with Ezekiel, Isaiah, Daniel, Zechariah, and the book of Revelation, as we have pointed out in earlier teachings. Curiously enough, and as I pointed out in many other cases, the feast, although regarded Jewish, has everything to do with Yeshua. Hanukkah is the eighth feast in addition to the seven feasts that we have in Leviticus 23. And it lasts 8 days, and 8 lights are lit from the central light, which is called the Shamash, the servant. And we find the number 8 all over it. And it so happens to be that Jesus' name, which was given to us in Greek first, has the numeric value of 888. In biblical times, Greek letters were also used for numbers, just as in the Hebrew language. When the candles are lit, a phrase is recited. And in Hebrew, that is Maldikin Shemona Yemei Chanukah. And it means, we light throughout the 8 days of Chanukah. The first letters of these four words form the word Messiah, Messiah. Hanukkah is called the Festival of Lights. It is all about light. And it is celebrated on the ninth month, the 25th day, Kislev 25. And the first time the word light appears in the Bible is in Genesis 1, verse 3. And that happens to be the 25th word in the Bible. Let there be light, it says there. So, no matter how dark this winter is going to be, if you have Jesus, Yeshua HaMashiach, in your heart, there is light. Have your lamp filled and burning. Let its light shine for all the world to see. There is not much time left for all these things to be fulfilled.